Ja, dann ist gut.
That's
one thing about Italians. You never ever put it.
See you later. Nah, you can.
Right? Well, not just that.
But you just feel guilty, so you keep eating.
You keep eating. Well, that, they give you a digestive, so you can go outside, come back and eat some more.
Saturday at lunch, I had a big lunch at my mom's house in the year. Then we went to an engagement party, which I didn't eat anything for. And then from there we went out for dinner at a Malaysian restaurant or
something
different. For my husband's house. And then on Sunday afternoon we all had a big family lunch with all the family. And it's like everyone went to this, so it's like a table of like this big full of food and everyone grabs what they can.
Okay, well, this big dog
is
that?
I don't
think
it's
the worst when it comes to eating. Is it the same as the time? Is it your greeting, like, good morning, have you eaten?
Well, my mum, you know, when she rings me, it's like, have you eaten yet? And I just know, it's like, well, what are you going to make? What are you going to eat? And then even in the car today, my husband said to me,
first thing I do, what's for breakfast and what are we doing for dinner?
See, my sister is like that. Like, I'm not normal. Well, I'm not a normal child as well. I don't never think about food. That's the only time I do that. As my sister will eat breakfast by herself, what should we make for lunch today? Can I just eat breakfast first?
The routine, the preparation, getting it together, it's too much of an artist.
I don't like it. My parents are straight off the boat, so everything was seasonal. So you knew it was Easter because we'll be making all the biscuits. You know, we have, you know, for we had to make sure we had the salami. Mum and Dad made salami from scratch. And then, like, the gnocchi, you have to make
scratches,
you know, and then Mum would be the one making the dough and be there, like.
Such hard work.
So,
does she use the finger or the fork?
No, we use the finger, and you got it, and there's a certain technique to it, yeah. Well, she taught us the two fingers, and you have to put the dent in and roll it.
You know what dent?
The gnocchi.
You know what dent?
Because it captures the sauce.
Everything is there.
It's kind of weird when you get that gnocchi, it's just like a
big ball.
Yeah.
Others, what they do is they get the fork and they roll it up the
fork. Yeah. But I find they're a little bit bigger. Sometimes it's harder to digest.
No, I don't understand.
So, what you do, you make the potato dough, like the pasta, right? Tomato, potato, egg, a bit of milk.
Yeah.
And you knead it all into a dough, and then you sort of got to cut that up into little pieces, and then you've got to roll it out like into a snake. And then they chop it again into a little rectangle shape.
Yeah.
But if you just cook that, it doesn't catch the sauce. So what you've got to do is make that rectangle into more like a shell shape. So like you can get two fingers, you press it down, and try to roll it. So when you cook it, you put the pasta, it catches
some
of the...
You know, it's making me very hungry. Now the feeling.
You can make it two ways. You can make it with the...
A lot of work.
A lot of work.
Well, We'll work with it. Okay. We'll work with it.
My mom used to make like half of it.
Number.
Yeah, you've got a number. Have you got a number?
Thank you. Spread some verses. And
we're trying to Thank you. warm light. Thanks. Number of rounds. Okay, I'm looking for a draw. They're the only ones that have discounted. Everybody else is actually got their draw. Okay? Let's hold them. But the choice was to go two divisions or we're done. But when I looked at those number of rounds, we're still having 10 rounds.
Is that including the
volume? Yep.